We dealing with certain pop on the line. Now, saints, you imagine how Jesus often, he meditates and wonders, how could he bring a child of God into riches and wealth? You imagine how Jesus often meditates, how could I show my daughter, my son, how much I care about them, how much I love them, how much my passion is for them, and he want to do it through a demonstration that you can visibly see. Now, saints, I want you to hear this. Powerful. It's powerful. But Jesus often has to not be himself around a child of God, because if he be himself, you're going to have to be extremely rich. Listen. Now, this is powerful. Jesus often, listen, watch this. He got to water down who he is, because you scared to drink different type of water. The water that y'all have to drink from him is going to make you rich. See, out of your belly shall flow rivers. Isn't this the same river stream that we saw in Genesis for Havilah? You ever thought about it like this? It said, out of your belly shall flow rivers. One of these rivers is Havilah. Genesis 2, 11, 10, whatever it was. One of those rivers is riches. One of those rivers is wealth. One of those rivers is Havilah. So listen to me, sons and daughters. Your wealthy place in God is in your spirit man. My gosh, shout out, boss. Your wealthy place in God is in your spirit man. That's why you understand I got the revelation. Because out of your belly shall flow rivers. So all these rivers. No wonder Ephesians 3:20 said he'll do exceedingly abundantly above all that you ask or think, according to the power that works in you. The power that works in you. The power working in your spirit, not even your soul. You got to get it over to your soul. That's why I say acts or think. Because that thinking realm, you let that power sit in your soul. You let that power get over to your soulish man. But your spirit already in Havilah. Your spirit already got a stream of money dominion. So your spirit already got a stream where you dominating over money. So it's not something that you got to pray and beg for, like he got to create and invent some type of new theology to help you live money blessed. It's already a part of your spiritual lineage. It's already your spiritual dominion. It's already one of the rivers in your belly. But you got to press to get there. There's a press that every sower has to step into to get to your wealthy place. You got to overcome dustiness. You got to overcome trials, tribulation, persecution. You got to overcome wrong voices. You got to overcome your own feelings. You got to overcome your own bank account. Your bank account want to prophesy to you and tell you stuff. You got to overcome loneliness. If you're going to step into wealth, you got to overcome loneliness. Because loneliness is going to try to sit on you. And loneliness is a demon that crushes financial prosperity. If you're not careful, loneliness will make you forfeit your God rights, make you forget the dominion that you got. Loneliness is the Judas of divine expectation. Loneliness can be the Judas of divine expectation. It'll betray what you was expecting God to do. Now, saints, isn't it crazy that for when nobody is around you, somebody is around you. You just can't see them. And most time it's a demon. Because demons love when you're not around people, then demons start talking about you. Ain't nobody love you. Look at all you done been through. Ain't nobody care about you. Shut the hell up, Satan. If nobody cared about me, Jesus wouldn't have died on the cross. If nobody cared about me, I wouldn't be having this knowledge I got about God. If nobody cared about me, I wouldn't have this type of wisdom. If nobody cared about me, I wouldn't be watching Prophet Joshua Holmes. See, if you don't shut hell up, hell gonna stay open. You ever thought about that like that? If you don't shut hell up, hell gonna stay open. And what's gonna do when it's open? It's gonna operate on you. Don't let the gates of hell open up over you. If you walk in God's gates, all the satanic gates gotta be shut. All demonic gates gotta be closed. But you gotta stick with God's gates. What's Psalm 100 say? Enter into his gates with thanksgiving. Them gates. See, Isaiah 60 verse 11 is talking about my wealth gates as a child of God. I got rights to these wealth gates. These wealth gates is where wealth is going to flow to me. I'm going to have supernatural wealth in money, in riches, in prosperity. It's going to touch me. Even if God got to use somebody to get it to me. Wealth gates, once you get access to this gate, you gonna find that there's investors at this gate. There's investors at this gate. This gate got investors. It got people that love helping you. They love blessing you. They're not jealous of you. They're not insecure. They're not trying to destroy you. They love being a blessing to you. The wealth gates show. In the wealth gates, you're going to find out that there's people that have been governed by love to love you. You ain't got to convince them to love you. They already want to be in love with you because that's the Holy Ghost working through them to show them that you are somebody that's Saul. Whether you know it or not, some of y'all talking, so, well, maybe I'm going to become Saul soon. Maybe God going to make me Saul soon. Maybe God gonna make me some soil. I'ma keep on sowing to baby. You don't understand that you already soil. If you got a paycheck coming to you, that means that you soil. If any type of money flowing into you, that means that you soil. Here's what I want you to catch. There are soil graduations. Now this strong, this strong, this strong. There are soil graduations. So that means that you already saw, but you can graduate to the next dimension of being a soul. And then you graduate to the next dimension of being a soul. And then you graduate to the next dimension of being a soul. There's soul promotions. There's sowing promotions. Sowing promotions is where God will anoint you to sow at a greater level. Sowing bountifully. There's sowing promotions where God will put more seed in your hand to sow. And there are sow promotions where he'll put more power on you to reap at a greater dimension. So some of you all have not even thanked God for the sow that you already are, but you're looking for God to make you the sow that you want to be. But listen, if you learn how to steward the soil that you already are, then you can get to the soil that you desire to be. The soil that you currently are is a test. Black people don't know how to say thank you. That's a nigga spirit. You can't be a nigga and be rich. You got to choose which one you want to be. Learn the law of going to the Lord and telling him thank you. Because then pride not going to set in. When I look over at what I got and I say, thank you, Lord, humility just overwhelmed me. I'm like, Jesus, okay, I got it. Oh, yes, Lord. What you want? What you need? Because humility hit me in that state. Black people don't know how to say thank you. Black people could have been got their money if they learned how to say thank you. They don't know how to say thank you. The spirit of entitlement is on the black race. No, I'm preaching to black people because that's most people that follow me. I got white people following me. I got Spanish people. But I'm saying you're not raised up in a race where they teach you how to say thank you too much. Some of y'all teach your children to say thank you. You teach them manners, but most black people ain't got no manners. Don't let the nigga spirit come on you, son. Don't let the nigga spirit come on you, daughter. Learn how to say thank you with your mouth, not with your mind. Oh, I said thank you in my heart. That's a nigga spirit. Saints, sometimes I meet strangers, they doing stuff for me, and I tell them thank you. They're like, oh, wow. You're welcome. That's so nice of you. Because they think that your reaction is going to be nonchalant because it's been nonchalant so long. Look, if somebody at the grocery store, you at the grocery store, somebody help you, don't up there just see them do it and say, all right. No, no, no. That's Jesus helping you right there. So tell that person thank you. I'm telling you, if you're going to walk in kingdom money, you got to learn kingdom manners. If you're going to walk in kingdom money, you have to learn kingdom manners. Kingdom money is subject to kingdom manners. See, watch this. Sowing is actually me showing respect to God. I'm showing him, Lord, I know that you gave this to me. I know that you provided the job for me. I know that you allow Social Security to give me money. I know that you allow me to have extra money. I got food stamps. I know you allow me. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to respect you and say thank you so much. See, saints, if you get the revelation that my sowing is actually a gift of respect to my God, I'm telling my God, I respect you. Thank you so much. You didn't have to do that, but you did it. You put money in my hands. So as a result, I'm going to sow to let you know I appreciate what you're doing for me. Remember the Lord thy God. For it is he that gave you power to get well. When I'm sowing, I'm putting Jesus in remembrance. I'm telling him I didn't forget. You the one that made me wealthy. You the one that put food in my mouth. So because I know it was you, I'm going to invest what I got into you. And the more I'm investing, he ministers seed to the soil. The more I'm investing, he ministers seed to the soil. The more I'm investing, he ministers seed to the soil. The more I'm investing, he ministers seed to the soil. The more I'm investing, he ministers seed to the soil. The more I'm investing, he ministers seed to the soil. Until you in billionaire status. Until you in trillionaire status. Until you are. You done stepped into the glory of God. You don't even know what happened to you. The The power of God done hit you. The glory of God done hit you. You done stepped into the Spirit. And the Holy Ghost done took you into the treasury. Because he gonna keep on ministering seed to you until you get to a level that you gotta sow in the hundred thousands. Because big money, big Jesus, big Jehovah Jireh, God over everything, God over Satan. These minister of finance, minister of finances know how Jesus roll. He know how Jesus operate. He done seen Jesus make so many people rich. The minister of finances understand the divine jackpot. That minister of finances was the one in the kingdom as a sowing angel. Every time the minister of finances came before God, minister of finances had a seed in his hand. Minister of finances was always sowing. Jesus saw one day, saw fit to make the minister of finances the sowing angel, the minister of finances. The sowing angel got promoted. Now he's over God's riches and wealth. Because he was sowing more than the other angels. Not that they was demonized. They're not demonized. The same way. Sometimes you're not demonized. But you just don't know yet how much Jesus is in love with the seed. You got to learn. You got to be trained. But I'm going to tell you something. If you are non-sower, you're going to have a lot of dry spurts in your walk with God. And saints, Jesus like a man that wants sex and he not going to say it with his verbal mouth. He hoping that you'll get the hint. See, let me tell you something. Some of you all put Jesus in an uncomfortable place. Because when he walking with you, when he living inside of you, he got to keep on telling you, I want you to praise me. I want you to thank me. He wants you to get to the place where he ain't got to be in that uncomfortable place to keep on telling you to praise and give him glory and forgive your enemies and walk in love and walk in humility and walk in the fear of God and walk in a supernatural servanthood. He don't want to keep on having to tell you. You trying to get it on. I want you to lick my ears. Lick your ears? Yeah, because you mean your earlobe? Yeah, this. See, now saints, let me just, I picked something that don't make no sense so that you can't figure me out, all right? That's all. I picked something that you can't, so that ain't, please. Yeah, man, you lick your finger in that ear. Lick your ear out, saints. That's what a lot of believers do with Jesus when he talk about sowing. You want to see? You want me to give my money over? Ew, I don't want to do that. And so the relationship cold. Because Jesus looking for seed. And you done made up in your mind that seed is disgusting to you. Sowing is disgusting to you. Giving is disgusting to you. Worshiping God with your finances is disgusting to you. I'm just giving you an example. I'm just giving you an example because you're married to Jesus. You understand? That's why the Lord take care of you as his man, as his woman, because there's a covenant marriage between you. You are the bride of Christ. That's why we're going to have a wedding supper of the Lamb in heaven. Everybody going to get married to the Lord because you're his bride. Don't be afraid when people ask you, who my husband? Jesus, my husband. Shoot. There was a show that came out called Different Strokes. When you're sowing, you gotta have different strokes. You gotta know how to stroke the soil that God gave to you differently. How to plow the ground differently. You gotta have different strokes. You gotta know how to sow creatively. Ain't that powerful? Creative anointing for sowing. That's why Apostle Paul was telling them to purpose in their heart to give. Well, he was teaching them how to sow supernaturally. He was teaching them of how to function in seed in a powerful way. Because now creativity will overtake your honor, your sowing anointing. See, having a sowing anointing means that you're in the master's realm with God. Masters. You're not just getting no degree. You done passed degree. You're in the realm of decree. Because your soul and your soul are armor bearers of your prosperity. They serve you into your prosperity. You caught that? Your soul and your soul are armor bearers to your prosperity. Your soul and your soul. Now, that's why when you sowing, God gonna put you in position to receive greater wisdom. And when you receive greater wisdom, God gonna put you in position to sow. I'm gonna say this again. When you sowing, God gonna put you in position to receive greater wisdom. And when you receive greater wisdom, God gonna put you in position to sow. So here's what happens. When I'm receiving the wisdom of God gonna be the usher. It ushers me into sowing. But when I start sowing, then the Lord gonna prescribe and schedule a higher level of wisdom so that when I get to that next level of wisdom, it'll be the armor bearer to get me to the next level of sowing. And the purpose of me to get to the next level of sowing to get to the next level of reaping. Let me tell you something. There's two types of people. Those that are in position for sleeping and those that are in position. As a matter of fact, there's three types of people. Let me say it like this, as a matter of fact. There's people that are in position for keeping. And there are people that are in position for reaping. The people that are in position for keeping have signed a written agreement in the spirit to have the same finances for the rest of their life. Or you'll have to steal, cheat, lie, and hurt other people to get it. You're going to have to be in the rat race with everybody else trying to get it. There's people that are in position for keeping. There's people that are in position for reaping. And see, Satan was the one that created saving consciousness so strong that it birthed stubbornness. So when God telling me to give, I done fell in love with what I have. So I love what I have more than God, but I don't know that I love what I have more than God until God tell me to give it, and there's a struggle, and I wait so long until the anointing to sow leaves me, so even if I do sow, I gotta sow out of law and not out of grace. Lawful sowing is burdensome sowing. Because when I'm sowing out of law, I'm just doing it because I'm just doing it because God says. So there's no fire. There's no joy. There's no cheerfulness. There's no creativity. Saints, let me just be real raw here. Imagine you doing an activity that you enjoy with somebody that's not enjoying it. You might be on a water slide. You might be on a ride at a carnival. And the person like, you over like, woo! 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 It'll kill the life out of the ride that you was enjoying. So you got to think about that when you worshiping God. That's why I say God love a cheerful giver. Because you imagine God like, woo, they about to sow. Woo, woo. Turns the hand, Jesus. Niggas did me wrong at my workplace for me to get this 20. You don't know why I had to go through to get this 20, but here. You want 80 more dollars? All right, $100 on there? I got to pay gas. I got to pay gas for Niecy them. When I pay gas for Niecy them, I got to drive over to the pit stop and pick up my Marlboros. Here, Jesus, then. $80, $100 and all. You imagine how Jesus not moved. See, the ride was exciting, but the activity of the person that's accompanying the ride is not. That's the same way sowing is exciting for Jesus. But if you're not excited about sowing, you kill the life. That's why most people don't get rich. Because they're sowing out of obligation and law. They're not sowing out of revelation and grace. See, I'm excited about sowing. I sow every day of my life. There's not a day that I breathe on the earth that I don't sow. So oftentimes, your attitude is magnified before God more than your fruit. If you're taking notes, write that down. Your attitude is magnified before God more than your fruit. Your attitude is magnified before God more than your fruit. Saints, all God was looking at was Cain and Abel's attitude while they were sowing. Cain was sowing out of law. He just was sowing because he knew that God said to sow, but he wasn't giving God what he wanted. Abel was sowing out of grace. So he enjoyed it. He was like, wow. I'm like, oh, Jesus, yeah. Hallelujah. Sowing. Hallelujah. Sowing. Saints, well, a lot of people don't know that Abel had unlocked the minister of finances to be his personal partner. If you're taking notes, write it down. Abel had unlocked the minister of finances to be his personal partner. So Abel had the minister of finances ministering to him at a dimension of God power. Because when you sowing, the God power will be released on you. And then you start living like a God. And how you know you step into the God realm? Because now you start delivering other people from their dilemmas. That's what gods do. That's how we roll. That's what gods do. That's how we function. I was on Facebook. The Spirit of God spoke to me while I was online. He said, son, we can't talk about riches and wealth on here. He said, you know why we can't talk about it? He said, because there's nobody up in here other than your people that I'm trying to make rich. He said, all these other folk need to hear about getting their mind right and being delivered, because they're not in a position to carry no large money bags. They're going to get on my nerves with all that money. If I put all that money in their hands, they start walking in wealth, they're going to get on my nerves. They're going to betray me, and the money going to go right back to Satan and his demons. You notice I switched up, right? Turned into a message of salvation. But that's you can't get no wealth God's way and you up there, no thief, no demon, no evil spirit, don't want to listen, take no instruction. The more money you get from God, the more he's going to place a demand on you. Where you at? Oh, no, I ain't got an answer to you. All right, give me my money. The more God anoints you for wealth, the more he's going to place a demand on your soul. Saints, I couldn't be depressed if I tried. I got too much God inside of me. God don't get depressed. I got too much of God inside of me. You got to see things. You don't study what's not going to edify your soul. You got to see things. You don't study what's not going to take you to the next level in your prosperity and wealth. You understand? It's okay for you to see stuff. Watch. See police brutality. Don't study that, because then you're going to develop a spirit of hatred. You understand? You understand? See slavery. Don't study slavery, because then you're going to think white people against black people. You understand? You got to know how to see things and not study it. When you study it, it's going to become a part of you daily, all day, attitude, mindset. You know how many people don't watch a movie? They done took on the movie, now they think it's their personal life. Why? Because they didn't know how to see instead of study. They went go study what they saw. Hereby, you understand the apostolic mystery. That's why God most times hides things from you. Because you think that you can see it, but God know that you're going to study it, and it's going to become a part of you, and it's going to get you kicked out of your place of favor. Many are called to true worship, but only few soul. Somebody write that down. Ain't that powerful stuff? God gave me that statement earlier today at 8 a.m., I believe. Many are called to true worship, but only a few soul. Let your seed work for you. Let your seed give you the mind of Christ and transfer it. Let your seed be a bridge to be saturated by glory power. Let your seed take you to the next level. Your sowing take you to the next level. Let your sowing bring you into the God realm financially. Let your seed destroy mental demons. You got to let your seed preserve you. Because when you sowing, you flowing in the DNA of God Almighty. You sowing, you flowing into the DNA of God Almighty. Let your seed protect you. Let me tell you something. Some people don't sow enough to be mentally free. See, I sow so much seeds that even if I consider being sad, I can't. Because saints, what does a man got inside of him? We got something called sperm seed, meaning if we do, it's going to make you have a child. You're going to get pregnant. That's God power inside of a man. Now let me show you something. You imagine the God power inside of your money seed. When you sow a money seed, the God power for creation is being released. So what is it creating? What you dreamed about, what you desire, what you long for, what you ask for, what you hope for, what you need. Is releasing God power for creation. So every time you sowing, you are operating in an artistic anointing. You become an artist for finances. The anointing of wealth is a kingdom mystery. Because to get to this anointing of wealth, not only do you have to have faith, but you gotta have works. Faith without works is dead. And faith without sowing cancels bread. That second part is mine. Both of them mine, but the second part is a fresh revelation. You're going to cancel out bread. Faith without works is dead, and faith without sowing cancels bread. What? Listen, I want you to hear me. Every day, Jesus got new money for you. Every day. Let me show you something in the text. What did Jesus tell them to pray? Give us this day our daily bread. Let me just tell you something. Jesus got prayer requests. He got prayer requests. One of his prayer requests is that your faith fail not. You know how I know that? Because that's what he prayed for Peter. Remember he said, I prayed for you that your faith fail not. What did the Bible tell us? That he maketh intercession for the saints. So Jesus got prayer requests. He prayed for your faith not to fail. Number two, what's the second prayer request of Jesus? He prayed that thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Jesus prayed that nothing will stop his will to provide for you. Let me tell you something. I know this so strong. Let me tell you something. You know why I talk about God like that? Because I'm a God myself, and I know the power that I have and what God be telling me when I'm dealing with people. Saints, let me tell you how I roll. You know what I do? I can have about $1,000 on me, right? Guess what God would tell me? I want you to give this person 200, give this person 200, give this person 200, give this person 200, and give this person 200. That's how Jesus rolled with me. So I say, okay, Lord. He said, son, study who sow out of the 200. And whoever do so, after they sow that, give them the next level of provision. Children of God don't know how stupid they are. Let me tell you something what stupid means. That means to have evidence of knowledge from God inside of you, but to be lackadaisy to use it. So what some children of God do, you know what? Oh, this is the 200. Oh, shoot. This is the 200,000 I was looking for. I didn't see God done answer my prayer, boy. God done answer my prayer now, boy, now. That's what I was looking for right here. Now, you're not going to tell me that. Get your hands off of me. Uh-huh. Amen. That's what I'm talking about. I got my $200 that I was praying for. I'm good. For the next 2 days, give me 2 days. I already owe a ticket, about $150. I only got about $50 left, but I'm good. So I'm good. guess what's happening? You just ate some little chunk change that God was giving you as seed. You know what a thief do? This is what a thief do. Let me show you what a thief do. This is what thief do. All right, you see this here? This is what thief do. Watch. God's selling accounts, right? Right, so this is what God does. Now watch this. I'm going to show you something, and this will change your life if you listen. You watch me with an evil eye, you're just going to be stuck on stupid. I'm doing this for a reason. Here's what God does. Watch that. Listen, God got your real money right here. Now this ain't no money. This really the money that God got for you. But this is what he gonna do. Now watch this. Watch. But he only gave you this. But this the money that he got for you. So watch, this is what you do. This you right here. Ooh, baby. Ooh, God done bless me. All right. The Lord done bless me. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let me see. All right, Jesus. Won't he do it? I got a $2 boy. Come on, nigga. This nigga don't know what they're messing with. I'm not rich, boy. He's going to talk to this. He's got breast milk all on the 200. Cow milk all on the 200. Jesus got this waiting for you. So this what you do. Let me start up in my bank account. welcome to the bank teller. What can I do for you today? I got $200 I'm trying to put in my account. Do you want it in your savings or your checking? I want it in my savings.
No, we gotta save. Y'all niggas ain't gonna take all the money from us. Shoot, I know about slave talk. You's a white woman. You's a white man. A white man. He's a white boss. That's why I ain't coming in. I'm gonna do this from my car. Because if you saw me in person, you might take one of the hundreds. So I owe taxes. I don't owe no taxes. The lady at the window like, ma'am, I don't know what you're talking about. Did you want me to deposit the $200? Yes, I want you to deposit $200. Saints, and God got this money right here. And this is what God do. God looking at you the whole time. Look, this small money. And watch, God got to look at you the whole month like this. Do you know it's tormenting to God when he can't give to you? Because you got a bad spirit. Do you know how much God get tormented when he got to look and know that he got this for you, but he got to sit right there and look at this torment? So watch this. This is what you live by. And God's standing posted up, the minister of finance is posted up like this. Hold on. Minister of finances. Watch this here. I'm going to pick the dog. Pick this dog. So watch this. God looking at him, watch, he's going to pick two. He's going to pick two, drop it on you. And pick two in your hand. Now he got this for you. But watch, you got the tool in your hand. Watch, little Mickey's a thief, and little Mickey done pit in her bra. Mickey, get this out your titty. Mickey, what you supposed to be on Disney? This is rated R. You supposed to be PG-13. Close your legs, Mickey. Close your legs. Close your legs. Watch this. And God got this waiting for you. Watch this. So watch. Then God, because he loves you so much. Let me tell you something. Do you know that sometimes God break the law? Because he ministers seed to you even though he know you're not a sower. No. You got to understand the mercy realm is when God break the law. Remember the Bible said he don't treat you as your sins deserve. Oh, Jesus. So watch this. Sometimes you can be sinning, but he not going to treat you as your sins deserve. Man. So watch this. Why are you sinning? Look at this. Why are you sinning and you think, Lord, he not looking at me. No. Oh, watch this. God done gave you two, right? He know you're a thief. But this is what he going to do. Watch this. Watch this. He put two more down. Because he hoping that you'll catch the memo. And then watch Mickey say, Mickey and Elmo is related. Yeah, put it in a bra. Mickey, you got these hundreds smell like breast milk. Hundreds smell like breast milk. A joke, baby. So watch this. So watch. God done put more seed in there. Because God hoping you get the memo. Watch this. So this is what God do. He's still operating in mercy. So watch this. He put two more down. Watch this. You know where this is going? This is going to saving account. Now watch this. Here's what I'm saying. Now you subject to trying to save. To get to your financial level. Well, watch this. Mickey can just sow and unlock all of this right now. Watch this. You can watch this here. Mickey can fit all this right here. Boom. 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 Watch. Mickey done put all of that in the bosom, right? And Mickey done made this a harvest. But watch this. Look what Mickey could do. Mickey could say, all right. So this, all right. So, all right. I receive it, Mickey. All right, let it go now. Let it go now. You're not going to grab me. Let it go, Mickey. Get off of me, Mickey. Yeah, give me the dang on to. Give me the dang on to. And you up there just preaching. Thank y'all. She done jumped on. Mickey done got off me. Get off of me, Mickey. Dropped on me. Where the ushers at? Y'all ain't see that? Damn old ushers ain't even come help me. They let Mickey jump me. No, you fired. I ain't gonna let you come back next Sunday. You ain't see Mickey just got me? Mickey just jumped on me. Don't let Mickey just grab me like that. You supposed to do something. See, watch. When Mickey get out the hospital, look at that. So watch, Mickey's soul, watch this. Look what God do. You see that? You see that? But see, Satan trapped children of God with where you at and what you make. He trick you in that realm. So here's what happens.
you start making the money that you do see your God, your way of support. And the money that you do see is supposed to unlock the money that you can't see. So here's what the devil do. Make you fall in love with this money that you can see, so that the money that you can't see will stay locked up and invisible in the invisible realm. And this is the invisible account. So watch this, saints. This is what the Lord was doing to me. He'll drop some money in my hand, right? Bam, this will happen. Instead of me go get a hotel room, right? This is what I did. I didn't just live in my car because I was homeless. This is what I did. I got large money. This is what I did. So, all right. God said I could enjoy this a little bit. Buy me some food. So. Now watch. I'm so strong. So God got a switch up in the bag that he just let me carry. He can't let the bag stay the same. Watch. Because thou violate the sowing and reaping law that he created. Because the purpose of sowing and reaping was to get you into the God power for finances. So he got to switch up the bag. So he not going to come back with this same amount. Now he's going to dump more on you than that amount. Now watch this. While I'm going through this phase with sowing, my joy is going to the next level with God. And my consistency. And my excellence. And my perfection. And while I'm sowing and I'm taking money to worship God, my soul is being purged of wickedness. My soul is losing its desire for bad habits. I don't want to smoke no more. I don't want to drink no more. I don't want to do none of those things. Why? Because the anointing. While I'm giving, I'm not just giving to nothing. I'm sowing it to Jesus. So the Jesus realm got to come on me. And Jesus is free. He was tempted in all points, yet he did not sin. So the Jesus realm got to come on me. It don't got no choice but to come on me. So watch this. While I'm moving in this place with God, I'm being taken over by the Lord. For supernatural increase. And watch. While I'm sowing this money, it looked like I'm just giving money, money, money. But what I'm stepping into is a glory zone that's purging my soul from a lot of wounds, a lot of hurts and pains, stuff I've never been able to utter to nobody, things that I can't speak to nobody. And God is going into the deep inward parts of you. 8 years old, 5 years old, 15 years old, when you lost your virginity just because of peer pressure. How you felt violated after you went with men, never mind, man single. And God go revisit all the moments in your life where you just did stuff because you didn't want to be talked bad about, and then it landed wrong in your favor. And the stuff, you never got healed from the stuff. But watch, while you worshiping God, see, people will look at you and say, oh, you giving away all your money. No, I'm giving away all my worship. And while I'm giving away my worship, I'm tapping into the glory cloud of God, And this glory cloud is taking me into the supernatural power of Jesus Christ for me to no longer have anything holding me back. See, a lot of people think that sowing is just you giving money. No, no, I'm giving what I have to worship the one, the only one that I need to have. You heard that? Right? You saw that? When you sowing money, you giving what you have to receive the only one that you need to have. You showing him Jesus, this right here. You more valuable than this. And when you pick that type of approach to Jesus, Jesus says, let me tell you something. It's the Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom. Now, no good thing will I withhold from you. See, saints, let me just tell you something. When you are a giver, God will show you how to heal yourself. No, because you might wake up in a bad mood for no reason. Because demons may visit your bedside without your knowledge. Not even know. And try to drop a little atmospheric blanket on you. And when you are a sower, Jesus will teach you how to heal yourself. The Lord will say, go get your earphones, put some music on. Listen to something right now. Change that mood. Huh? Come on. Look around. Just be thankful. What all did I do for you? Do you remember? Huh? What you believe in me for? What you dreaming about? What you desire? Come on, write it down. Write me a letter. Saints, how many letters have you wrote to Jesus? I wrote hundreds. I had a book. Of just writing letters to Jesus. Lord, I love you. I want to thank you so much for what you've done for me. Not no words, letters. Because writing is therapy for your soul. Lord, whatever you want from me, I'll give it to you. Write it down. Lord, I change my mind from anything that's not of you. And Holy Spirit, I value your instructions and tell me what to do. Even if I didn't feel like it or I won't feel like it, I'm still going to get it done. Because you mean more to me than life itself. If I got to go through any pain or persecution for you, I'll do it. If family don't understand me, I'll go through it. Jesus, if you just take me over and use me, that's my biggest dream come true. Holy Spirit, I realize that all I want in this life is to hear your voice. If there's anything that will magnify above your voice, please drive it out of my life. Hijack me so that it won't be there. Write it. Write it. Write it. Write it. Write it. It's better than letting demons sit on you, and then you never get free. See, oftentimes you look at stuff like that and say, well, I don't got no time to do it. You don't got no time not to do it. Well, I work 12 hours a day. There's 24 hours in a day, baby. I work 17 hours a day. There's 24 hours in a day, baby. You can go on your lunch break and write. Write the vision, make it plain, which shows you that there's two realms that writing produces. And I know that's spelled plain, P-L-A-I-N, I know, but I'm dealing with plane, airplane. When you're writing, you're activating vision. So now, how you see things, your expectation, your imagination is going to come alive. You see that? Write the vision, make it plain. Write the vision. So writing and vision are related to each other. So oftentimes your mind will shift while you're writing. Saints, you can say what you want. If I felt somebody was stupid, I'd get angry real easy. I've always been like that. I think the only thing made me angry if I think that you're being stupid. So I used to want I wanted me a Whopper Jr. Mom, can I get a Whopper Jr.? No, baby, not right now. A fat spirit done came on you. You done went crazy in your mind because you done got a soul tie with food on the low. I was like, forget it. Started writing. Started writing. Because you know your mama would throw a shoe at you, and she always accurate. It don't matter if she got a headache, a toothache, an arm ache, she's still going to be accurate. Like, and you done dodged. Like, you done... And she still got you. Your head done went back and forth 100 times in 2 seconds. And she still landed. Like, mother, you work for the Matrix. That's what you do. You be running as fast as you can. You still get hit. Your mama up there got a boomerang spirit. And then it's like when she hits you with the object come back to her and fling back into her hand, and she done threw it again. She done threw it twice in one time. It done boomerang, it hit you, then it double back, then came back into her hand again. She done threw it. Whoosh. Writing is therapy for your soul. Oftentimes, while you writing and God leading you to write, you'll feel the power of God and the presence of God. Your feel. Saints, I used to have in my phone, and I still got in my phone, I got notes. It's stuff that I never preach, ever. I got notes of just letters and phrases that God give me when I'm writing him the letter. Because Jesus reads your letters. Sometimes you're not in a place mentally to be talking. Do you know that there's a place where you can talk to God and get worse? Because that's not the proper approach to him at the moment. Do you know that you can go to the Lord and feel worse after you went go pray? Then before you went go pray? Because you're not sensitive to the flow of the spirit of what you should be doing. Saints, do you know that there's sometimes when you come to the Lord in prayer that he don't really want you to say nothing at all? And if you in a I gotta say something mode, you're gonna say it even though the spirit don't want you to say something, and you're gonna mess up the vibe of God, which will set you back in having the manifestation, the encounter that you're looking for. Because what happened is, it's like you intruding on somebody. Now, imagine this. I never walk in nobody's room. That's one thing I don't do. In my life, I have a law. I never intrude on nobody. I'll never walk in somebody's room without them knowing. You understand? Because my mother taught me manners. It's kingdom manners. You don't violate private people's privacy. Say somebody on the phone, right? I'm not going to listen to your conversation. Now, if God wants to show me something, he can show me something prophetically. I got a prophetic on me, he'll show me. I don't got to dip and dab in people's stuff. I don't check people's business. I stay in my own business. And so, it's kingdom manners. I never violate nobody's privacy. You can never be around me and say that I ever violate. There's not one person on earth that can ever say that I violated their privacy. Never. Because I never walk in on you. I never step in on you in something that's private to you. If it's private to you, I'm going to respect that as private. I'm not going to violate, you know, because sometimes you might be on the phone talking to me, Mama, I need some drawers. I need them now. Like, and then now, you got big drawers? I said, we're size 38. I wear size 38, man. Don't you call me no nigga again. I'll slap you, boy. I'm sorry, Mama. I thought I was talking to the boys. I thought I was talking to the boys. We were watching football. But I need size 38. You don't need to hear nobody asking for no draws from their mama. That's their personal information. Now, it's not harmful what they're asking for, but it's none of your business. Then every time you see old boy, you're going to think about draws. He want them big old 38 draws. What you still wearing draws for, man? You supposed to be grown. Now you're out there clowning them. You supposed to be grown, man. What you still wearing drawers for? Like you a little child. Like you wear Flintstone drawers. My brother, you got flat Flintstone on your drawers. It's a daggone shame, man. You got Flintstone vitamins too, man. You still eating Flintstone vitamins? Talking about it's going to strengthen your immune system. They lied to us. I mean, y'all used to eat them vitamins. You still ended up having a cold. You ate the vitamins and still got a cold. You ate the vitamins, still got sick. Thompson, the vitamins is going to strengthen your inward. It ain't do nothing. I still had a cold like everybody else. Everybody was up there. You up there doing the same thing like everybody, spinning a cup in class. Give you that little Flintstone pills, and some of them was horse pills. You choke on it. I remember when the doctor used to prescribe pills. I used to look at big old horse pills. I ate one of them. I did eat one of them, but I threw away the rest. I said, "This is violating my man code. I ain't having it." Shoot. Big old horse pills. I took one of them horse pills. I said, "Dad, I ain't taking it no more, Mother. I'm just..." Mother was like, "You take the pills?" I said, "Yes." Sure, I'm like, "Jesus, I'm supposed to take them pills." I said, "Son, you ain't got to take them big old horse pills. The doctor be up there trying to tell you take all types of stuff, especially when you get older too. Saints, you go to a doctor sometime, they'll tell you that stuff is for prevention. Meaning you ain't got nothing, but say, "Oh, but just take this so that you'll never get it." No. See, saints, some of y'all, let me tell you something. We going into the flu season soon. Ain't that crazy? We going into fall. Don't be up there taking no flu shot. Don't take no flu shot. You know what the flu shot, they put in the flu in your body. let them make you sick to say that they're going to prevent the sickness from coming on you. What? Don't listen to, see, let me tell you something. There are certain aspects where you respect people in authority, like doctors and stuff, because they'll know certain stuff. But don't be taking no injection in your body. Tell us it's to protect you from the flu. No, I ain't got the flu. So what happens is you'll find yourself letting something come that's not even supposed to be in your body, and they're telling you it's going to prevent the sickness, and you don't need it. You don't want to mess yourself up hearing the advice from people that's not going where you're about to go. Don't let people interject knowledge into you if they have not produced what you're attempting to produce. Billionaire status is going to make demons laugh at you. Because demons are thieves. While they looking at you and they seeing you following the Lord concerning your finances, of course, they're going to make a mockery of the way that God is doing things through you. Of course, they're going to make a mockery of what the Spirit of God is teaching you to flow in. Of course. Of course. Because the realm not revealed to them. But it's your job to stay in the realm and manifest the realm, because this path is a straight and narrow path and many people can't go here. Now, Saints, let me just say this. There was a reason why the children of Israel, after they got the silver and gold release, now they're functioning back in an adversarial spirit. Because, Saints, here's what happens. If you gonna get large money and you don't got large surrender, the money gonna destroy you. It's gonna get to your head. See, they had large money, but not large obedience. So the thing killed them. You catching that? You catching that? You catching that? Trillionaire grace, trillionaire and billionaire grace is locked up inside of Jesus, is locked up inside the prophet, the apostle, is already in the spirit realm. It's just waiting for somebody that will live in the spirit concerning everything. Because, Saints, you imagine, what if you a billionaire, right? And the Lord tell you, I want you to fly to 5 countries today in a jet. Imagine if you're depressed, you ain't gonna do it. Imagine if you're depressed, you ain't gonna do it. Because watch, the more money you got, the more instructions God give to you. See, saints, that's why when you sowing, you can hear God so strong. Because what happens is you open up a realm where he excited. See, God get excited about money. And God use money to excite you. Because that's the God realm. If you sowing, nobody can tell you that you love money. Because if I love money, I would not be giving it back to Jesus. If I love Jesus, I'll give the money. So if I'm anointed for money, nobody can tell me that I love money. No, I'm anointed because that's what I'm giving Jesus. So of course my mind is going to ponder on money subjects. Because this is the avenue in the street in which I'm worshiping. And I'm receiving a harvest of what I'm worshiping God about. My God. And he teaching me in the same street in which I'm traveling, which is sowing. So because I'm sowing, he gonna talk to me about finances, because this is the realm that I'm obeying him in, and this is the realm where he promising me and prophesying to me and letting me know that this is where he going to meet me, because this is where I met him. And he telling me that I shall reap good measure, pressed down, shaken together, running over, men give it into my bosom, because this is the avenue in which I took. I stepped into Luke 6:38. Now say, let me just tell you this. You know when Jesus started saying that he was talking to his disciples? When he said, given it shall be given unto you, he was talking to his disciples. Here's what I want you to see. He was training the disciples about the seed, because this is what they was about to train the church to move in. So saints, okay, Jesus is telling them, I'm going to give you the keys of the kingdom. And now he's giving them the keys. He letting them know, this is what you're going to do, so that my kingdom can sit on you and you'll have the demonstration of my kingdom very strong in your life. So he letting them know, this is going to be the avenue in which I'm going to teach you to take. And then I'm going to have you teach the people that I send you to, so that when they sow into you, I'm going to make you like you are me. And so you're going to produce what me produce, which is multiplication in your soul. See, saints. Peter was the largest sower in Jesus' ministry. That's why Peter had such authority with Jesus. Who Jesus revealed the supernatural money to? Peter. Who did he tell him that the money in the fish mouth? Peter. Because Peter is sowing. So you notice that Jesus didn't reveal the supernatural money in the fish mouth to nobody else but Peter. Because Peter is the largest sower in Jesus' ministry. Look at the privileges that Peter has through his sowing. Because sowing unlocks privileges, sowing unlocks power. Those two different statements. Sowing unlocks privileges, sowing unlocks power. Sowing unlocks pleasures forevermore. Peter is in a place of dictatorship with Jesus Christ, to the fact that when the Holy Spirit falls, he gives the interpretation of what's going on. Everybody said, these people are drunk. Peter said, no, they are not drunk as you suppose. And he begins to prophesy underneath Joel's mantle, which Joel
Jarl himself understood about the seed. Jarl was a sower.
My God, I ain't never heard that before.
Jarl was sowing, and Jarl experienced the restoration of years. That's why he was given the authority to prophesy about the Lord shall restore unto you the years. That's how come he knew. He knew about the years being restored because he was a sower. He knew about supernatural restoration and how to break these financial demons off your life. Strongholds of cankerworm, palmerworm, locust, and caterpillar. That's why he knew about this. This is why Jarl knew about this financial army. Because Jarl was sowing. Because Jarl was sowing, he knew how to teach on what will break this army, this financial army of demons that God sends. You imagine that? God be sending financial demons because he know the child of God need to be quickened to sow. You imagine how Jesus sent the financial demons because the child of God needs to be quickened to sow. The child of God needs to realize that this is not all the money that you're supposed to have. There's millions and billions of dollars that are scheduled to get to you in this life, and you must not be distracted by the cares of this life and foolishness and nonsense. You got to stay and keep your hand to the plow and keep on sowing, keep on praising, keep on submitting, keep on surrendering, keep on thanksgiving, keep on worshiping God, and keep on giving your body, soul, and spirit over to King Jesus and let him use you. The bigger picture is you gotta press. Not get depressed. Not let oppression sit on you. You gotta press. See, in the word press, there are several words. In the word press is pressure. Because when you pressing, it's because there is pressure being applied. And watch this. There's a pressure that comes from demons, and there's a pressure that comes from the Holy Spirit. And sometimes the Holy Spirit putting pressure on you to get back to your prayer language. He putting pressure on you to be more thankful. Because ungratefulness not only betrays God, it betrays you. The children of Israel did not only betray God and Moses, they betrayed themselves. Because they was the one that groaned and asked the Lord to come deliver them. Now they delivered and they can't even see it. They get right back into the bondage that they were set free from. Ungratefulness is a betraying spirit. It'll betray God, it'll betray who God sent, it'll betray you. Because that demon ain't got no friends. You get the word pressure. There's a pressure that comes from demons. It's called anxiety. Try to push you in the wrong direction because they start having you look at time.
Oh, this the time. I don't see nothing, so I'm going to do this.
Pressure, demonic pressure. Evil spirits have you looking at the natural realm. And now you feel the pressure. Oh, I got to do this. I got to do that. And God like, no. Well, no, I got the pressure on me. I got to do it. No, don't do it. And Balaam goes and do it anyway. See, Balaam was underneath demonic pressure. You ever thought about it like that? Balaam was underneath demonic pressure. So God telling him, no, don't do that, Balaam. Don't go. Balaam said, nah, I'm going to go. God be all right. I'll see you later, God. Shoot, you take it too long. There's demonic pressure. There's the pressure that comes from Jesus. You got to know what you're dealing with. You going to walk in wealth? You got to know which pressure is adversarial and which pressure is divine. Because see, when Jesus was telling Peter, watch and pray, that's divine pressure. When the Lord was telling Joshua to walk around the walls of Jericho 7 times, that's divine pressure. This is supernatural urgency that comes from God. When God asks Ezekiel, can these bones live? That's divine pressure. Pinning divine pressure. You understand? Divine pressure is where God now is. He not letting you stay lukewarm. He not letting you stay in complacency. He pushing you out. Divine pressure is when God goes the route that you didn't want him to go. That's why many people fall. Because the pressure of God is not the pleasure of God. If you pass the pressure, you'll live in the pleasure. But you got to prove yourself in the pressure. You got to press. Not get depressed. Not let demons have you oppressed. Not be suppressed, but press. When you sowing, you pressing a button. You pressing a button. You pressing a wealth button. When you sowing, you pressing financial buttons. The seed like a financial gadget. You pressing. What you do when you're in the elevator? You gotta press a button. You can't get to the next level unless you press. What did Apostle Paul say? I'm pressing, Makarapa Soto, towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I press. When you press, then you get to another realm of the word press. You impress God. Somebody spell impress. Somebody spell it. Those of you out there can't spell, let somebody spell it that went to school 88 years. That was with the Hebrew children in Jerusalem taking study classes and semesters. What word do you see in impress? I'm press. So God becomes impressed when you become. Pressing. When you become pressing, God becomes impressed with you. When you become pressing, it takes over your nature. It takes over your mind. It takes over your reactions. Now, you become. The pressing anointing. So how could the devil stop you? when you press it? How could feelings hold you back when you press it? Laying aside every weight and the sin that so easily beset me. Hebrews. Why? Because you pressing. If you pressing, what could stop your money from coming to you? See, let me just show you this. Think about it. There are buttons in the spirit. Remember Jesus said, knock and the door shall be open to you. Let me ask you something. Being that God is a technology God, did you ever think that the door, some doors, had buttons connected to it? Have you ever thought? Because if you look on earth, not every door is the same. Some doors you open with a key, some doors you open with a button, especially an elevator button. So if you're going up the financial elevator, the wealth elevator, the money elevator, your sewing is pressing buttons. Telling you, all right, I done mastered level one, I'm going up to level two. Sometimes you so strong that God say you're going up to level four. Skip three. You so strong, he say you're going up to level seven. You don't skip five and six. Because the Lord saying you sowing too deep for me to keep you at fifth and sixth, because you done sold into those realms already. And watch, every floor has a different scenery. The same way, every floor that God got for you financially got a different scenery. You ever notice you go on a floor in a mall, they got pots, pans, all type of stuff. The next floor, they got jewelry. The next floor, they got clothes. All materialistic things. That's why your materialistic life will go to the next elevator, the next floor. Because you're pressing buttons with your seed. So now, hereby, you understand the mystery, the apostolic mystery of all other things shall be added unto you. Because you're on another floor. You're on another floor. And every floor got its own release of substance. Every floor got its own release of prosperity and wealth. So you keep going to the next floor, the next floor, the next floor.